Hello everyone, welcome to Code and Learn. Today we are going to talk about caching and Redis. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Why do we need cache? You have probably already encountered a problem that plagues us all. That is the dreaded loading spinner. You know, the little circle that mocks your impatience. Fetching or loading data from the database is expensive, and a lot of time you spend as a developer is to increase the performance of fetching this data from the backend or any data store. Well, developers also came up with a solution to this problem called caching. We will understand how caching works and why Redis is the king of caching. So imagine your application running on your laptop or your mobile device needs to fetch the same piece of data like user profile information over and over again. So it will be making round trips. Every single request means a trip to the database, which involves network latency, then disk IO, and the processing time. So every time you're sending a request, it's like recompiling a complex piece of code every single time you want to run it. That is, you would have to go through the network latency and then the database latency each time you want to fetch your data. This is the reason we have cache. Instead of constantly hitting the database or your primary data store for frequently accessed information, you store a copy of this information into a cache. A cache like Redis. Caches are much faster, temporary location that enable you to retrieve the data instantly whenever your application needs it. So this trip here to the cache is much less expensive than the trip to the database because caches are in memory. That is, they temporarily store the data in their memory, while databases store the data in the file system, which involves I/O and thus is expensive. Now, there are many caching solutions out there, but there's one that becomes the absolute rockstar of caching world, that is Redis. But why all the hype? Is it because it has a cool name? Maybe a little. But seriously, Redis is popular for some of the seriously good reasons. Let us look at them. First one, it is super fast. Redis is an in-memory data store. This means it primarily operates with the data held in the RAM, not on the slower disk drives. Even though nowadays we use SSDs, accessing data from the RAM is still faster than accessing from disk drives, as accessing data in-memory provides near instantaneous read and write operations, making your applications incredibly responsive. So that enables your users to experience blazing fast loading times. Second, it's super versatile. Redis is a key value store, but it's not just for simple string. It supports a wide array of powerful data structures directly, like string, lists, sets, hashes, sorted sets, streams, etc. This versatility allows you to model complex relationships directly with your cache, optimizing for various use cases beyond the simple object storage. It's like having a Swiss Army knife for your data structures. Then we have the integration with the different coding languages. Redis boasts robust client libraries for almost all major programming languages and frameworks. Whether you're working with Python, Node.js, Java, Go, Ruby, PHP, or C#, there's a mature and efficient way for your application to interact with Redis. It seamlessly fits into virtually any tech stack that you may have. Then, it's highly scalable. Redis is built for performance and high availability. It can handle an immense volume of concurrent reads and writes, and it offers advanced features like replication for data redundancy and read scaling. You also have clustering for horizontal partitioning and extreme performance. It's designed to grow with your application's demand. Let's go to the diagram again to understand a bit more about caching. So how does the caching magic with Redis actually work? Imagine your user sends a request to a frequently accessed data like the user profile. So what will happen is, the very first time your user sends a query to your main database, for example a Postgres database, and retrieves the information, it displays the profile to the user on your client. But at the same time, the return request will go through the cache actually, so that a copy of the same data is stored in the cache. This caching is typically done with the expiration time. Now, for all subsequent requests for the same data, that is the user profile, your application request will go through the cache. It will check if the data exists. If the data exists, it is sent back to the client. If not, it will go through the database again, fetching the data, going via the cache and saving a copy in the cache. So next time, when the request comes in for the same data, it can be fetched from the cache in a much faster way. This process drastically reduces the load of your database, minimizing latency, and makes your application snappier and more responsive. It also makes your application able to handle many more concurrent users without performance degradation. It's like having an ultra-efficient data proxy always ready for your answers. So now that you know why we use caching and why Redis is a king of caching, let me talk a bit about the project. I wanted to give an introduction to caching and Redis before we went into the project. In the project, we are actually going to build a Redis server from the scratch. So we will be covering TCP connection, which the Redis client will use to talk to our Redis server. Then we will also cover the Redis REST protocol. REST is used to communicate between the client and the server so that both can understand what each other is saying. Then, since we are building a server, we need to handle these connections in a concurrent way. So, we will look at concurrency as well, which gives you a practical way of testing and working with concurrency. Along with that, we will also look at performance and a bunch of other things. If you are excited for the project, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks again for watching the video. I hope you liked it. Until next time, happy coding!